Welcome back. Today, inshallah, we'll continue with the life story of the legendary Sayyida Aisha. She said, when I arrived, I became ill. I wasn't feeling well. I only noticed that the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam is not treating me the same way. Usually when I am sick, he usually asks about me. This time he is asking about me, but it's not the same way, he's different. And the wife usually knows. And then she said, maybe there is something else going on. So I asked him, can I go and stay with my mother and father till I feel better? And he said, go. Meanwhile, there was no revelation of the Quran in Medina. And everyone is talking about it. And the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, you can imagine. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have taught us, is to ask. So he went and he asked her servant, what do you know about her? And she said, I don't know anything but all khair. The only fault she has is if I have baked, if I have prepared the dough, and I will tell her, keep an eye on that dough, she will go and play and leave the dough, and then the sheep will come and eat it. Otherwise, this woman has no faults. He asked Sayyidina Ali, and Sayyidina Ali said, Ya Rasulullah, we don't know anything but good about her. But if that's so much bothering you, there are other women also. Then she's still in her parents' house. She went one day feeling a little bit better, went outside to relieve herself. And with her was a relative of hers and her father, the mother of Mustah. And as she was helping her, Sayyida Aisha tripped, but she didn't fall. And that the mother of the relative said, Ta'isa Mustah, woe on Mustah. Sayyida Aisha said, why are you saying this? This is a man who attended Badr, this is a companion, and this is a very righteous man. And the woman told her, you don't know what he said about you. And she told her. And then she said, everyone is saying this? People are talking like that about me? Does the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam knows? And the woman said, yes. And she said, from that moment, for the next 3 days, there was not a single dry eye for me. Stayed in her parents' house, Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam entered, sat in front of her, she was crying. And he said, Ya Aisha, if what they are saying is true, say it and ask Allah for forgiveness, and He will forgive you. She said, the moment I heard this, there was no more tears coming out. She described it as my eyes were dry. She said, I didn't say anything. I looked at my father and I said, Dad, you answer Rasulullah. Sayyidina Abu Bakr didn't say a word. You can imagine the feelings in that house at that moment. She looked at her mother and says, Mom, you answered Rasulullah. She didn't say a word. She looked at all of them and she said, I am not going to say anything, but what said the father of Yusuf? And then she commented, I didn't even remember his name, said to his sons, Sabrun Jamil, beautiful patient. And I turned my back to everybody. What a woman. At that moment, she said, I noticed that something changed in the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, and the Quran was revealed. And then he looked at her and says, Ya Aisha, your innocence came. And you can imagine the joy. And the father and the mother looked at her, and Allah revealed, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ جَاءُوا بِالْإِفْكِ عُصْبَةٌ مِّنْكُمْ لَا تَحْسَبُوهُ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ. Those who came with the false accusations, group of you, don't think this is bad for you. It is good for you. And the whole, it's about 6 to 7 verses in Surah An-Nur, chapter of the light. So you can imagine the joy. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr looked at her and says, come and hug Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam and thank him. And her mother said the same. She said, no, I am not going to thank, but the one who knew I was innocent and who he sent my innocence It's Allah. And then she said, I knew I was innocent and I knew Allah will show my innocence, but I never thought I am worthy in the sight of Allah that a whole Quran, a whole verses of the Quran will be revealed, that will be read till the end of the days to prove and to show my innocence. One of her uniqueness, Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, died in her room and actually on her chest. And the last thing he tasted was actually her saliva. She said, somebody, as he was very ill, alayhi salatu wasalam, almost in the last breath, she was so smart, and she said, I noticed someone was using a miswak, and I felt Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam wanted it. So I took it from the companion, and I actually moisted it with my saliva and put it in his mouth. And she said, the last thing he tasted was my saliva. And he passed away, alayhi salatu wasalam, in her house. She lived years after him. And she was the most knowledgeable woman in Medina. Kibar al-Sahaba, major companions, they used to come and ask her opinion and what she thinks of this ruling and that. She passed away in Ramadan, 17 of Ramadan, at age 66. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with her. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all learn from this story and all her life and the legacy she left behind her.